Hello everyone, my name is Mrinal Kanti Sen. I'm from India. I hope my screen is visible to you. I'm here to present my work on flood resilience quantification using dynamic patient network model for housing infrastructure system. During my presentation, the following are the content which I will discuss one by one. Initially, I will discuss the definition of resilience, then different type of infrastructure, then disaster worldwide, then damage houses due to flood, then motivation, research gap, objectives and results and conclusion. And lastly, I will discuss future work. The definition of resilience is the withstanding capacity of a system against a natural hazard and bouncing back to a desirable performance after a disaster. So the performance of a system mainly depends on different time zones. In the figure, the performance of a system is shown during its lifespan. Here A point is represent the initial point, which is equivalent to 100%. Then A to B is the degradation in the performance due to aging effect. Then B point due to occurrence of any hazard, the performance drop down to C. And C to D is the recovery profile, which mainly depends on several type of factor like infrastructure, natural condition of the community. And again, D2 is the degradation due to aging effect, and CB is the loss. T1, T2 is the recovery time, CD is the recovery profile, CT1 is the resisting ability. Next, according to the definition of resilience, resilience mainly depends on 4 R factor, which are robustness, redundancy, rapidity, and resourcefulness. Robustness is the ability to resist the effect of a disaster. Redundancy is the availability of alternate resource ensuring operational requirement during or after the disaster. Rapidity is the time taking to bounce back to the original or desirable performance. And resourcefulness is the availability of resource for recovery. If you combine these two, like rapidity and resourcefulness, we can say that it is equivalent to recovery only. Next, there are several type of infrastructure out there. Like basically, community deals with 2 type of infrastructure, like social infrastructure and physical infrastructure, where social infrastructure consists of like population, income, education, etc. And physical infrastructure consists of housing, transportation, electrical, telecommunication and water. As housing is the basic need for a living being, that's why in this world we have considered the housing infrastructure. And dependency among the infrastructure also plays a very important role for functionality of any community. If I talk about any disaster worldwide, we can observe that from the left hand side figure or table, India holds the 2nd position in total death toll due to hazard. And in the right hand side table, we can observe that due to flood, maximum number of population get affected in 2020 as well as in average of 2000 to 2020. That's why in our work we have considered the flood hazard. There are some these are some figure of affected house due to flood hazard. So due to flood, if I talk about global economic loss, is estimated as $8 billion in March 2019. If I talk about India, the average annual loss is estimated more than $7.4 billion. The average loss due to flood in Assam, which is a state of India, is estimated as 2 billion Indian rupee. From 2014 to 2020, more than 1950 houses got fully damaged and 37,500 houses got partially damaged in the state of India. So we can observe that from this data that due to flood, every year many infrastructure are affected, and due to which government is sanctioning huge amount of restoration costs, which also affect the economy of the country. So motivation of the work is like, as you know that like we cannot stop or reduce the impact of any hazard. In that case, what we can do, we can develop a strong framework by applying the concept of resilience, which will be robust as well as quickly recoverable. As housing infrastructure is the basic need, so we can apply this framework in that infrastructure to make more resilient. As we know that like resilience requires several type of information from several type of sources, so there might be a chances of involvement of uncertainty also. So while applying the resilience concept, uncertainty should be considered. These are some research gaps as follows. Like resilience is discussed in many domains such as ecology, social science, and engineering also. But concept of resilience in housing infrastructure is relatively new, and very few literature is available for housing infrastructure against flood hazard. Resilience is discussed in several types of hazard also, but in flood hazard there are very few literature are available. Several types of framework or model are proposed for quantification of resilience, but uncertainty in resilience of housing infrastructure is not addressed well. Dependency among resilience parameter of housing infrastructure is not studied till now, and time dependent housing infrastructure also resilience is not studied ever till now. So based on the discussion, the main objective of the study is like to develop a robust dynamic resilience analytics framework for housing infrastructure, considering dependency against flood hazard. And the specific objectives are like develop a resilience model for housing infrastructure resilience against flood hazard, then decision making approach to improve the housing infrastructure resilience, and quantify the time varying resilience against flood hazard. So this is the proposed framework. The right hand side figure shows the different steps involved in the modeling and quantification of dynamic resilience. Here initially different experts are selected from different domain, then based on the expert knowledge and literature, different resilience dependent parameter of housing infrastructure against flood hazard are selected. After the selection of resilience parameter, a resilience model is developed as shown in left hand side figure. As resilience required various information about the previous disaster, so an extensive field survey is performed for the collection of data. Then based on the collection data, the probability of each parameter is assigned, and finally by using Bayesian belief network, the flood resilience at different time period for each surveyed area are calculated. As quantification of resilience like required expert knowledge also, so in this work we have selected 11 experts from different domain as shown in the table. Here two field survey from DDMA department, which is also known as like District Disaster Management Authority, are expert in awareness generating regarding the natural and man-made hazard. Then DPO is district project officer from same department, is expert in preparation of disaster management plan. Then AEA, assistant engineer, is expert in development of and planning of urban and rural area. Then the two assistant professors are expert in seismic risk management, reliability analysis, resilience assessment, interdependent network system also, and MCDM tools also. And lastly, like five catastrophic modelers are from different industry, are specialist in vulnerability, climate, and flood. So after selection of expert, various resilience parameters are selected based on four key parameters as we have discussed in definition of resilience, like vulnerability, robustness, rapidity, and resourcefulness. Based on the literature and expert knowledge, these are the selected parameters like type of house, flood depth, building age, then drainage availability, wall thickness, and etc. So on. These are all total, like we have selected 32 parameters in this study. So the developed framework is implemented in Barak Valley, northeastern India. A field survey is performed to collect all the required data. From the figure, you can see that the area is in low elevation zone, which is more vulnerable against flood hazard. The reason is selected because from 2014 to 2020, more than 600 houses are fully damaged, and more than 30,000 houses are partially damaged in the district of their valley. Next, we have used the Bayesian belief network, which is actually a belief network or Bayes network. It is a probabilistic graphical model which represents a set of variable and their conditional dependency with the help of directed acyclic graph. In the network, three type of node exist, like prior, intermediate, and child node. Each node has various probability states. In the figure, we can see that a node A represents the parent node and node B and C represent intermediate and child node, which means B and C are dependent node and A is non-dependent node. It means here B and C will have conditional probability and node A will have prior probability. Here all the nodes are having three probability states such as low, medium and high. In the right hand side figure, we can see that like a node A are having only three probability and node B and C are having total nine probability as they are conditioned with A. Next, dynamic Bayesian network. Dynamic Bayesian network is the extension of ordinary Bayesian network by capturing the dynamic behavior of static network at different time. This network mainly has two type of plates, such as temporal plate and non-temporal plate, where nodes in temporal plate changes with time and nodes in non-temporal plate are static, which means do not change with time. This network has two types of dependency, self and with other, as shown in the middle figure. So where self means node A depends on node A which with changes of time, such as node A at time t plus 1 depends on node A at time t. With other means node B depends on node A. Here we have a two type condition, means two type of, we have a total two cases, like which is with other cases. We have two type of cases, like first one is normal arc relation, which means node B depends on normally with node A. And second one is like order number relation, which means like node B at time t plus 1 depends on node A at time t. But in our case, we don't have this kind of relation. Additional dependency of node between non-temporal plate to temporal plate is not valid, or sorry, is valid, but temporal plate to non-temporal plate is not valid, as we can see in the right-hand side image. But in our case, there is a dependency between temporal plate to non-temporal plate. So, for example, we can say like a flood depth, which is a temporal plate, depends on drainage, which is non-temporal plate. So, to overcome this difficulty, we develop two type of approach for this dynamic model. So this is the first approach. In approach one of dynamic Bayesian model, initially a Bayesian network model is developed with including all the dependencies and find out the resilience of different time, so that we'll have the graph with time-based resilience, where y-axis we can put the resilience value and x-axis we can put the time. It also acts the dynamic as we are calculating resilience with different time zone. So this is the second approach. In second approach, initially I have developed a hierarchical dynamic Bayesian network in Jaini software without considering dependency among bottom layer resilience parameter and provide evidence to those nodes which are changing with time. For example, like flood depth we have, then relief receive, etc. The only disadvantage of this approach is that the evidence which like we have to provide the node which are changing with the time should be deterministic evidence, like low, medium, high. We cannot provide probability value of each state. Like if I'm having say low 40%, then medium 60%, we cannot provide the probability value. We have to give the maximum or deterministic probability value. This is the disadvantage for approach two. So next, using Jaini software and the developed dynamic Bayesian network, each time period resilience value for both approaches were calculated. Here total six different time period are considered. Initially, the resilience value for the surveyed location were evaluated separately for six different time period. Next, all the collected data were merged, and resilience value for the entire study area, which is Barak Valley, across six different time period were calculated, which is shown in, we can see the in the left hand side figure. In y-axis, the resilience value were represent the probability of resilience state, is high resilience state, and the resilience profile of the both approach are highly similar, which validate our proposed approach. In both the case, it is clear that the bounce back performance exceed the pre-disaster performance. It is because many householders switched to masonry to RCC house after their bamboo house were damaged by the flood hazard. There is a sharp increase in the resilience profile from time 2 to 4 in approach 2. However, time 3 to 4, that is the rainy season, heavy rainfall occur irregularly, which affect the recovery process. Additionally, from time 5 to time 6, resilience increase in approach 2. However, it is observed that almost all the houses recovered after Fifth, time survey. The changes should be very less, which can be seen in approach one, indicating that approach one provide more accurate results than approach two due to considering dependency, as approach one provide more reliable result, and the second time survey was done immediately after the flood hazard. So it can be conclude that like robustness is nearly 40% and of the housing infrastructure in Borag Valley. Which means like 40% of the housing infrastructure in Borag Valley can resist the impact of the flood hazard. Similarly, if you deduct the second time resilience value from first time, then the vulnerability of can be evaluated, which is nearly, you can observe like it is 0.121, which is 12.1. That means nearly 12.1% housing infrastructure is vulnerable to flood hazard. Next, using all the collected value and approach one, the resilience map for all the different time period are developed. The right hand side figure shows the resilience model for time period one. These are the resilience model for time 2 to 5. Here resilience map for time 6 is not developed, as it is identical to the time period 5. Here some conclusions such as Anipur Grant, Tarapur, Dulachara, Kanakpur, Rakhal Kharepura, these are the places in Borag Valley were found to have most robust housing infrastructure. Then Amjurghat, Tarapur, Vatikupa, then Pachim Kumdapara were found to have most robust recovery profile. The vulnerability and robustness comparison between all the surveyed place should help like stakeholder, policy maker, and decision maker. The recovery profile comparison should help the public authority to increase the availability of recovery resources for low recovery profile areas. Then in future, the framework will be useful for new case study as well as for any other infrastructure against the same hazard, as this study evaluate the static as well as dynamic resilience for each house. So in future, using simulation technique, the requirement like requirement probability for each probability for each resilience parameter can be evaluated for a targeted resilience. Next, those value can be compared with the cost so that economical as well as resilient infrastructure can be constructed for future flood hazard. These are some references which are followed during my work. Thank you so much. If you have any queries regarding my work, you can ask me in the given mail ID. Thank you very much.